video from the LumaTouch Academy, we're diving into the wonderful world of creating animated titles. Now, a few of you have asked me, how do I make my titles and my text look a bit more exciting within my LumaFusion projects? How do I add transitions? How do I use keyframing? Well, that's what we're going to be covering in this week's video. So if you have LumaFusion in front of you, please do get out your editor and you can do this along with me. If not, of course, pause, rewind the video as is necessary. So, first things first, how do we add some text to our project? Well, we can do that in two main ways. First of all, we can tap the Add Clip icon at the bottom of the screen, this little plus icon, and we can tap on Main Title, or if you have content already on your main track, you can add an overlay title. So I'm going to click on Main Title here, and you'll see I have a lovely little title pop up that I can then go and edit. The other way I can add a title is by going up to the media library, and I'm going to go into my menu here and I'm going to tap on titles. Now within this title menu, I'll be able to see all of the different standard titles that have already been created by the lovely folks at LumaTouch, and I can just drag and drop anyone I like onto my project. So let's have a look. Let's find one that looks a bit snazzy. I quite like the look of this one. I'm going to drag it in just like I would do a normal photo or video, and I'm going to drop it on the timeline. So you see two main ways of adding a title. We can either do so at the bottom using this Add Clip icon, or we can look all the way up to the top to this title folder here. So once you have some text on your timeline, it doesn't matter if it's something like this, which has obviously been highly produced, it's got lots of different layers within it, or it's just one piece of text. So let's go with something that looks a little bit like this at the moment, and we're going to talk more about how we can animate this. If I double tap on this, you can see I'm going to enter the title editor. Within the title editor, on the right hand side, you can see that this title itself is made up of shapes and text. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different layers within my title editor. Now, really, really important to know here, guys, that although I can actually access any of these individual layers, as you can see here, I can change the look and feel of any of these layers individually, this entire title as a whole is actually flat when it's brought into the timeline. So you can see if I go back onto the timeline here, this is one flat title. Now I can't animate any of the individual aspects of this title individually if I just leave it as one flat title. Now you see what I mean by this. If I now go to my menu up here at the top left and I click on transitions, you can see here I can add a transition to that title. I'm going to drag and drop the grow transition onto the beginning of this. Lovely. Now that's very basic, very simple, but very effective. So at the very least, guys, we can start adding transitions to our titles. Let's add one to remove it. So we're going to shrink it. And now you can see as it plays through, it's going to shrink down. Okay, fun stuff. I'm just going to take those off just for the time being, because now we're going to animate this title by actually thinking about the individual shapes and pieces of text within it. Now, we've just seen there that on the timeline, this is completely flat. Anything that's in an individual clip, like this title, you can see here, is going to act as one flat clip. You cannot animate, in this example, the rectangles separately to the circle when it's in one flat clip like this. So in that respect, what we're going to do here to animate this clip, I'm going to duplicate it on the timeline. So I'm going to tap on this duplicate icon here. And now you can see I've got two of the exact same title on my timeline. Because one is on top of the other, I can see exactly the same thing on the screen, on the preview box up here at the top right. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to tap on the top one. So double tap, open up my title editor. And what I'm going to do now is actually remove some of the layers from this title. When I remove some of the layers, it means that I can animate them separately because I've laid it up on the timeline. This is going to make sense in a second. So I'm going to just leave the text on screen. So I'm going to get rid of these shapes. Now, when I go back to the timeline, I'm going to do the opposite for the layer underneath. So I'm going to get rid of the text. So double tap on the layer underneath and get rid of the text. Okay, so now from the top, it looks exactly the same, doesn't it? It looks like we've got a circle with two rectangles on top and two pieces of text. But really, you can see here from this picture, we've just got the shapes down below and we've just got the text above. So now I can start thinking about how I can animate this a bit further. So for example, let's say we wanted to grow the shapes in, but then we wanted the text to come in and wipe to the right, for example. We can add a different transition on, maybe even start that a little bit later, maybe here. All I did there was just use that trimming handle to drag. And now you can see as I play this, it's going to be a lot more animated. Woo, that looks fantastic. Okay, so let's play around with that a bit more. Perhaps we even split the shapes up to animate those separately. So I'm just going to move this up a layer here. I'm going to duplicate this on the timeline. And as you can see there, I'm going to do exactly the same thing. So now this is a circle and two rectangles. I'm just going to get rid of the circle here, which I think is that one. That's it. And at the bottom here, I'm going to do the opposite. So I'm going to get rid of the two shapes. And now that's just a circle at the bottom. So now I'm going to add a different transition here to those rectangles. What can I find? What's a little bit snazzy? Let's do something, maybe a soft wipe up. That might be quite fun. Maybe even start that as the circle comes in at the same time as the text. Wonderful. So you can see I can really start adding animations to my titles by simply splitting up the titles here on the timeline. Now, if you didn't want to use one of the preset titles that's already been made within here in the title menu, if you didn't want to use any of these, what you could do is do what we did before, add a title to the timeline like we did here. We can double tap on it and we can make our own title. Now, if you haven't made your own title in the past, it's really simple to do. You're basically just going to use this section over here on the right-hand side to build your own title from scratch. So we've already got some text on screen. What we can do is we can tap this plus icon. Then we're going to click on a shape, an image, or another piece of text. So let's add a shape here. So perhaps we want this to be a beautiful bar across the screen. Just going to add some colors here. I'm just going to collapse that and bring that behind the text so we can actually see that text out in front. Let me just change that text here. Just have a little play around with some of the effects, some of the fonts, and so on. And as you can see, just making a nice little title for myself. I'm just going to keep going, add some shapes, change the color, move the sizes around, just really have some fun with this. I mean, you could be here forever. I mean, it's just completely endless possibilities of what you can produce here, which is really great. Let's add some more text here. I'm going to pretend this is a video for a birthday montage. Okay, so as you can see, playing around with some of the fonts, some of the colors, and when I'm happy, there I have it. I have my title, okay? Now, if I wanted to use this title again in the future, I could save this as a preset by using this icon here. Save that as a preset. Let's say if you were going to do, in this case scenario, birthday videos for a multitude of kids, so you could have party time. And you could save that. And it will appear in your preset titles, okay? So it will appear here at the top, and you can see those are the ones that I've made before. They're the user titles I've made in the past. You don't have to do that step, but if it's something you want to use again and again, that's where you're going to do it. So let's go back to the main home screen here. Now you can see I have my title. What I'm going to do now is add some transitions to this in exactly the same fashion as we've done before with that preset title. So again, we've got our title here. We're going to duplicate this on the timeline using that icon at the bottom of the screen. Now I'm going to double tap into that top layer and I'm going to blind some of the layers. So for example here, let's get rid of that shape at the bottom and the line above. And let's do the opposite for the ones at the bottom. So let's get rid of 12th birthday and party time. And now you can see if I go into my transitions, let's do a soft wipe up for the background and a soft wipe to the right for the text. Let's see what that looks like. Beautiful. In fact, just stagger it a little bit. Let's have a look. So you can see I'm really animating these titles. I'm giving them a bit more of an engaging, snazzy feel to them. Now, if you wanted to, you could really animate your titles by using keyframes. Keyframes are a little bit trickier to get your head around if you're completely new to editing. For those of you that have been doing it for a while or you want to learn something new, please stick with us. So let's try to animate a title now. I'm going to bring a new title in from the menu up here at the top left. And let's say, for example, what's a bit of a snazzy one? Let's go this one. I think this one looks nice. Shapes lower. We're going to drag and drop that onto that main track there. Again, we have our title. This is a preset title that's already been made for us. So if you didn't want to design your own title, you can just use one of those and change some of the text and some of the colors to suit your project. So instead of actually using a transition that's already done for us, we're going to create our own. So I'm going to double tap onto that layer. And I'm going to take my eyes downwards to the bottom of the screen to where we are in the frame and fit editor. Now in the title editor, this is where you're going to design your title. Over here on the left-hand side, the frame and fit editor is going to dictate where that title sits in the frame. Now, as we've mentioned, guys, really important to get our head around. If something is in one layer, in one clip on the timeline, that is treated as one flattened image, okay? So you cannot create a keyframe just for this red rectangle unless it's in its own layer, which is why I was talking to you about duplicating the layers on the timeline, blinding some of those internal layers if that's something that you wanted to do. So let's start by creating a keyframe for this title. Let's say, for example, we wanted this title to pop up on screen, dip down, and then pop back up again. I'm going to use these keyframes down here at the bottom left within the size and position tab to actually create a movement over here in the preview bar. So let's say, for example, I wanted this graphic to start hidden off screen. So I'm going to add a keyframe. I'm going to move this off screen like so using the sliders. Now, as soon as my video plays to about there, I want my graphic to completely be in full view. So I'm going to add a keyframe. And then one icon I like to use all the time is this one here, which is going to pop my graphic back to where it was originally. It's just an easy way to make it fit in frame really well. But you don't have to do that. You could use the sliders as well. So here we go. We've added two keyframes. If you haven't used keyframes before, please do go and check out our beginner's guide to keyframing. So you can see, there you go. We've started at this position and we've ended at that position. But remember I said I wanted it to go down and then come back up again. A bit of a peekaboo type situation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a keyframe about here, exactly the same, because I want it to stay in the same position. But about here, I want it to pop down. Okay, so I'm going to add a keyframe. So I've almost, doing the keyframes the wrong way now, because I've just kept it in the same position. But halfway through, I wanted it to jump back down. So about there, I'm going to add a keyframe. I'm going to bring this down a little bit, not all the way this time. And now it should jump up and down. Okay, so let's play that. So funky, huh? And then maybe we want it to whiz off the page at the end. We can add our keyframe there. And about that section there, we're going to make it whiz off to the right. Okay, let's have a look. Snazzy, huh? So basically we've added animation to our titles, okay? So we've seen here in this demonstration, you can do so using transitions over here. We can drag and drop them onto our titles. We can split our titles up to add extra animation to different parts, like so. Or we can add keyframe animations, depending on how comfortable you are. Happy editing!